At the Barcelona Lab for Urban Environmental Justice and Sustainability with INICTA, we do a lot of work on health inequalities in cities, looking at the different ways in which environmental exposures affect socially vulnerable groups in urban areas. So here, when we are facing such a crisis like COVID, what we study is the way in which some vulnerable workers are those more exposed to the virus because they have to keep working. They have to keep working to make an income, but also to have access to health insurance. That's, for instance, the case of the residents living in Chelsea, Massachusetts, which is a town of 40,000 residents just north of Boston, where the rate of infection by COVID is 4 times the rate of the state. And why is it the case? It is a case because those workers are those who drive ambulances. They are those who work in the food chain and food industry. They are those who work in elderly care or hospital facilities, and oftentimes make very little income, as little as $12, $10 an hour. And they have to keep working because they live in very expensive housing environments, Boston being one of the most expensive cities in the United States. And on top of it, because healthcare is depending on your employment in the United States. So they know that if they have to be hospitalized or if they have to consult a physician because they get infected by COVID, they might not be able to pay the $30, $40, $50,000 cost that this hospitalization might require. And so these workers are particularly vulnerable, and many of them are Latinos, many of them are working class residents who in general suffer from greater health inequalities and also in general are in much more precarious economic conditions. What we also are looking at are the ways in which people live confinement and the way in which some groups like children, especially lower income children who live in very precarious and dense housing conditions, sometimes with multiple generations, sometimes with multiple families, are really at risk of trauma because they cannot go out, they cannot practice physical activity, they cannot grow socially by being with other friends, they cannot go to school anymore. And here in Spain, for instance, we have the strictest level of confinement in the entire Europe. And children haven't seen, as of April 20th, any street, any park. They haven't been able to walk in more than 5 weeks. Those who are also particularly vulnerable are the elderly, because those groups need to practice physical activity, they need to walk, they need to be able to go out, first of all, to be less socially isolated, but just also in general, to keep their muscles working, to keep their confidence that they can be out and they do not fall if they are exposed to a sidewalk or to a street that hasn't been maintained. And here they are, also confined for 5 weeks without the ability to leave their apartment. And so in urban conditions, especially so in a city in Europe like Barcelona, which is the densest city in Europe, you really have a lot of inequalities in view of confinement. And of course, those groups who have private patios, private terraces, who have access to private green space, have many different conditions of confinement in relationship to those who live in cramped apartments. And that is also part of a study that one of our researchers, Francesc Baró, has started conducting as an online survey, trying to understand the inequities in confinement. And also just in general, we are looking at the ways in which the virus spreads through lower income neighborhoods, the way in which people as a response also draw and build on networks of solidarities to try to help one another, and how governments are responding in different ways to try to create a form of safety net for people, like minimal income, for instance, that would be something that the Spanish government seems to be working on, and how different governments are responding differently to this crisis.